Good day everyone and welcome to another tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to do toon shading in cycles. While I'm not going to be showing you how to do a character from start to finish, I'm going to show you how to get that flat shaded look, or cell shaded look, however you want to define it. But I'm going to start off with a quote from Thomas Dinges, who's a Blender developer. He says that the internal rendering engine, which is what I usually use for toon shading, was built for speed, but if you wanted realism, you had to turn stuff on. Cycles is the other way around. It's built for realism, and if you want it fast, you have to turn stuff off. Now, there's a correlation between toon shading and getting a fast result, because toon shading is not, for lack of a better term, as difficult to compute as realism is. That's why you have to turn stuff off. Now, last night, I was challenged by God to actually figure this toon shading stuff out for cycles, and it was a nightmare. But finally, just before going to bed, I was able to get a flat shaded look like this. You can see over here, this was actually done in cycles, and it didn't even take, you know, like fancy materials or these massive node setups and stuff like that. I mean, let me quickly show you what this skin looks like. That's the skin selected, and that's my compositing, not the material. There we go, there's the skin. Look at that fancy material. Looks like spaghetti, doesn't it? Ha! Anyway, as you can see, it's not complicated. It's quite a simple process. I will say this though, in order to get this look, you have to turn a lot of stuff off in cycles. But you do still get smooth materials along with toon shaded materials, just like you would in Blender Render. One thing to mention on speed, though, is that despite using GPU compute, I was not able to get a faster result with cycles. I would not say that it's not possible to get a faster result with cycles. I think you really can, because I've gotten faster results as I've tweaked this thing. It got faster and faster and faster, so odds are that it is a little bit faster at the moment. Anyway, without further ado, let me show you how to do this. Okay, so open a new Blender project. As you can see, by default, I've got a camera and a sun lamp, and my settings are set to Blender Render instead of cycles. So switch to cycles if you don't have it by default. Select GPU compute under device if you have a compatible graphics card or chipset. Under film, set it to box, just makes it a little bit faster. Under performance, use static BVH, it renders faster. Cache, persistent, use spatial splits, 256 by 256, that's what Andrew used to speed up his rendering in cycles. Turn freestyle on because we need some outlines, and under light paths, I'm not going to turn these off just yet because I want to show you what cycles typically does. So we are good to go. Screencast keys on. So add a plane and a monkey. Control 2 and smooth. Let's just move the monkey back. Go into the camera and let's just give some drama. There we go. A little bit dramatic. If you were to just render this right now, you would see that it's quite realistically set up. You know, like a almost like a late afternoon with porch lighting or something. I don't know. But everything is too smooth. This does not go down well as toon shading. In order to get toon shading, we need to turn all of these fancy things off. So to do that, we are going to be starting with our lighting. Going to your sun lamp, just tick nodes. If it was on Blender Render, you'd have to select that. Set the strength to be 2 or 3. 2 is usually good enough. Set the size to 0.001 to get hard shadows. The smaller the light source, the sharper the shadows. Multiple important sample gives you less noise, and I found actually made my test renders go a little bit faster. And that is good for our lighting. Now go into your world settings and turn on ambient occlusion. This will be used for our environment lighting, so just turn that down to be about a 0.1. And under ray visibility, turn off everything except camera. Remember, the goal is not to just turn stuff off for the sake of turning stuff off. You have to turn on stuff that your scene requires. For example, if you have volume and transmission stuff, transmission would be transparent kind of stuff that light passes through, you know, to get like caustics and stuff like that. And volume scatter would obviously be for volume. If you don't need these things, keep them off. Yeah. Settings, multiple important sample only makes it slower, so let's just not use that. There we go. That's good. Okay. Now you can change the color over here without worrying about the effect it may have on your scene. Let me just prove that. If you go to these on, see? All red. Don't want red. Just camera on. Okay. I'm going to set this to a nice soft green. That's nice. Okay. Now go into your render settings and turn these all to 0. Remember, you're going to adjust these as your scene requires them. Okay, now you see we have a very atypical Blender render type result. Now all you need to do is just toon shade it. So go select your monkey, say toon material, taking long to spell material over there. Under surface, select toon BSDF. Let's select that reddish pink color that complements the green. And let's increase the size. Remember that it darkens out as you increase the size. I have no idea why. Doesn't matter. Let's just up this to 2. That's a bit better. Okay. Just want to make it slightly stronger. Okay, that's good. And now what I want you to do is I also want you to add a normal object that does not have all those materials on him. So Control 2 again for Suzanne, and place it right next to this one, slightly down, a little bit more back, say back, there we go. And let's just turn this like that. Okay. Now if you were to render this out, you would see something like this. Looks awesome. What you can do now is you can also turn down your render samples. You can turn them down a lot. If you go down to sampling, you can set it to like 5. And you'll still get a good result. Only if you look like really closely in your render will you be able to see any hint of noise. See, like over here. But it's just wasting your time if you're trying to up it to like 500 samples or stuff like that. It's really unnecessary. And that's basically it. Toon shading is very simple in Cycles. It's quite easy to get this look as you just saw. I'm glad that God challenged me to do this last night, and that I even get to share it with you like today, so that's really awesome. I hope you can use this in your projects. Have a great day, and God bless.